I speak to you a minute?
Certainly.
Sit down.
Sorry.
Excuse me. Get you some tea?
Tea?
Sure. Got some milk or sugar in there?
No. Gosh, they don't give you much room around here.
That's part of the monastic oath. You know, worldly things distracting me from my teaching.
She's pretty.
She's also in London. Makes it a little difficult.
How can you stand it?
Stand what?
You can go anywhere. You can do anything. How can you stand being here?
Because I love teaching. I don't want to be anywhere else. What's up?
I just talked to my father. He's making me quit the play at Henley Hall. Acting is everything to me. But he doesn't know. I can see his point. We're not a rich family like Charlie's. But he's planning the rest of my life for me, and he's never asked me what I want.
Have you ever told your father what you just told me? About your passion for acting? You ever showed him that?
I can't.
Why not?
I can't talk to him this way.
And you're acting for him, too. You're playing the part of the dutiful son. And I know this sounds impossible, but you have to talk to him. You have to show him who you are, what your heart is.
I know what he'll say. He'll tell me that acting's a whim and I should forget it. They're counting on me. He'll just tell me to put it out of my mind for my own good.
You are not an indentured servant. If it's not a whim for you, you prove it to him by your conviction and your passion. You show him that, and if he still doesn't believe you, well, by then you'll be out of school and you can do anything you want.
No. What about the play? The show's tomorrow night.
Well, you have to talk to him before tomorrow night.
Isn't there an easier way?
No.
I'm trapped.
No,